If you teach online classes or you are thinking to teach online, then this video is for you. Because in this video, I'm going to show you an application which is best for this job and which is amazingly free. So let's get started after a short break. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Tahir, and if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Friday. Online teaching is a job which every educated person can do. You can get this easily nowadays, and the trend of online teaching is on a rise. There are many software available for online teaching, but this application which I am going to show you today, in my opinion, is the best for this job. This is called Classflow, and this is made by a company which is a well-renowned company for educational products. So in this video, I am going to jump on my computer and I will demonstrate to you how to get started with this application. It's a cloud-based lesson delivery software. You can create and deliver interactive lessons, assignments, activities, and polls. And these lessons can be delivered to students on any device, for example, their notepad or tablets or even mobile phones, which is connected to the internet. There are a lot of features in Classflow, but in this video, I will show you the basics to get started. If you teach online classes, you can use this amazing free application to deliver lectures. This product is from a company called Promethean, which is a company who makes award-winning solutions for education. So if you are an educator, you should visit their website. They have a lot of products for educators. And these type of applications are extremely useful for women who can earn some money by tutoring online students from their home, because they have to take care of their family, so they don't want to go out. They can just use Classflow software to deliver lessons. And I am going to walk you through this today. So let's dive into it. You can create a teacher account or a student account. So I have created both accounts to demonstrate this. So I am logging into my teacher account. So I click on login. And now there are four tabs here, as you can see, home, which is right now I am in home. And these are some of the mostly used tasks. So they have provided these icons for them. For example, I can start an instant whiteboard where I can explain something. I can solve a problem or whatever. It's just like a whiteboard. I can quickly start a poll or a survey, ask a question to students and they can answer instantly because they are accessing this lecture on their tablets and devices. And I will show you in a minute how this looks from a student perspective. I can create a new lesson, I can create a activity, I can create a quiz, but today I will start from this classes. So let us assume that you are teaching an online class. So I click on classes. And on the left hand side, I have this geometric class. And in this class, if I click on this class, I have this lesson. And here I can delete this lesson or I can share this with class. So once I share this with class, it will be visible to students. Now every class has a class code. And this class code you have to provide to your students and they have to enter this class code when they log in and attend your lecture. So now there are two types of enrollments you can create. So let's click on this new and then I add a class. And now we have two options. Student generated class, which is the recommended option, where students first open an account with Classflow and then they log in to your class by using a class code. And the second method is teacher generated class, where you create a roster of students. You put the name of students on a roster and then you send them the class link and the code. Now this is for smaller students. Let's say you are teaching primary school students where parents don't want their children to open an account, or the children are so small they cannot create an account. Then you just put them on a roster. Even if you use this option, you can still send the link to students and they can join the class without opening an account. As you can see that this red mark means that this is the essential field. I don't want to create any class for this video, but let me put any name here, algebra for example. And now as you can see that this option will be available for you to create a class. You can also select a subject from here. For example, algebra is in mathematics, and then you just say that this class is, let's say, for year 9. And now if I click on this, a class will be created. Okay, let's create the class. I will not choose it, but let's create. So now this is the class here. And now I will be demonstrating using this geometric class. So let me click on this geometric class. And this class has one lesson. And if I click on this lesson, I can show you the lesson. This is my lesson. And the way you create a lesson is, in Classflow, lesson is divided into sections. So this is section 1 and this is called card. So in PowerPoint we call it a slide, but in Classflow this is called card. So what happens is that you create a section, and on that section you put some background image for your branding, or you can select some images are already available here. You can select any of those, and then that image will be in the background of every lesson of that particular section. So this is how you create cards. So in this card I have put the image here. So let's create another card without an image. So what I can do is I can click on this gear icon, and then I can add a card. So this card is added. I can still put any image on this card if I want. I can change the background, but if I want this to be same as this section image, then I don't have to do anything. It will automatically appear. And now I have many tools available to create my lesson. I can put some text by using this text tool. I can put any shape. So let's put this shape. I can resize this shape. And if I click on this gear icon, I can rotate this tool. I can reorder. I can bring this to front, or bring it to forward or backward. So back means back to all. Front means front to all. Forward means one step forward, and backward means one step backward. So let's say that I drag this text and put here. Now this text is on back. So I can bring this to front by just clicking on this gear icon, and then reorder and just bring to front. So this is how you can add shapes and you can add text. You also have some tools available. If I click on this toolbox, I can add a ruler, and this ruler is not visible. So let's zoom in. I can zoom in by using this tool. So to keep it a little bit large, a little bit further zoom. So I want to show you a few things on this tool. If you click on this, you can rotate this, and it will show you the degrees here in the middle. What is the degree of rotation at the moment? If you click on this, you can enlarge this or decrease the length of this ruler depending on the space you have. If you click on this cross, this will vanish. If you only want this centimeter and millimeter unit, you just turn the other off. And if you want inch units, you can turn this off. So this is good when you are demonstrating something to your students. Now there are some other tools. So let's remove this tool and we take some other tool. For example, let's take some protractor. And now you can take the measurements of angle. Again, you can increase the size or reduce the size. You can change the units on the both side or just on one side. And you can also rotate this from this point and so on. So these controls are available, and you have all these tools. You have compass and square, widgets, spotlight and revealer, where you can hide the text and reveal the text or anything inside a certain area. So let's zoom out a little bit. So if you want to change the color of this image, you can just fill this with any color, select any color and the image, and then the color of the image will change. Now if you preview this lesson and see the difference, that here I have added image behind this card as well, and here I did not, but I have a image and the section. So if I preview this card, as you can see that my section image appears on the background. To get out of preview, just click on this exit. So in order to deliver this class, you just click on this deliver And now this is the icon. By pressing on this, you will send this to your student. So send screen to all students. So when you click on this, this lesson will be sent to your student. And the good thing is that you can also create some group of students, or you can send this lesson to any individual student if you want. And this is the powerful feature of Classflow, because you can send different assignments to different group of students depending on their capability. And this we will talk about maybe sometime later, but this type of features are available in Classflow. And if I click send, it will be sent to my students, and I will show you how it will look from a student perspective. Now, to log in as a student, you just type classflow.com/student on your device. And now the address at the address bar might change slightly, but don't worry about that. Just click on login. If you have created an account, click on login. And now my login details are already here. So you just put your student name and password and hit login. Now you are logged in, and you can see one message from the teacher at the bottom. So if you click on classes, then you will be presented with this screen, and then you click on geometry class. And now this is how you will see the lesson. You will not see all the working area of the teacher. You will only see whatever is within the boundary of a card. Now to go back, I can click here and I can exit from here. Now if I click on this hat icon, I have other option to get resources. These are my own resources which I have collected, but there is also marketplace available. So if I click on that, as you can see that other people have made many resources here which you can use. So all these resources which are free, you can use them as your lectures. So there are thousands of resources available for free which you can use to teach your students. And this is again a very powerful thing, because otherwise you would need hundreds of hours to create these resources. But these are freely available. You can also purchase. If you click here on paid, then paid resources will appear here. So these resources have some price tag, but very little. As you can see, $1 or just 99 cents, these kind of resources. So you can also purchase something if you really like that. So this was a brief overview of Classflow, which you can use to deliver online classes, and which is surprisingly still freely available to use. So I hope you like this video. If so, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. See you next time.